guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to contour and highlight your face. Basically, this is my updated highlight and contour routine. All the products that I use, the brushes, everything is mentioned in this video. So this is sort of a detailed long video, so I really hope you bear with me because I really want to teach all of you girls who do not know how to highlight and contour how to do it and how I do it basically. So if you want to know how I contour my face, then please stay tuned. Okay, so now I know I look weird. Everything is half on my face. But I just did my eyeshadow and eyebrows and lipstick. I put a little bit of foundation because we're gonna start like a step-by-step tutorial on contouring and highlighting, right? So that involves concealing as well. Just how you conceal also plays a big factor in highlighting and contouring, at least for me. So I'm just gonna show you how I conceal. So most of you know, typically I use two concealers. One is first to conceal these dark circles and then to highlight. So I'm gonna put it in really simple terms. I'm not gonna overcomplicate things. So the first product I'm using is the LA Girl Pro Conceal. This is an amazing product. This is in the shade Pure Beige. Now if I use a brightening concealer directly, you are gonna see some bluish green dark circles underneath, and that's not a very flattering look. You want your dark circles to be concealed before you highlight. So this is not bright, this is same as my skin. And I'm gonna take the Master Blend by Nykaa. This is the Nykaa sponge. I have been loving it and this is all I've been using. And I'm just gonna buff the concealer underneath. Okay, so now that I have concealed my under eye, I'm gonna move on to highlighting my face. So I have not set anything yet, like you know. So I'm gonna start highlighting with concealer now. This is gonna ensure that I am bringing out the areas that I want to. So I have a few concealers here which are really brightening. So all of these are a shade or two lighter than my skin tone. So that's what I will be using for highlighting. This is the Estee Lauder Double Wear Concealer. You don't have to buy this. This is quite pricey. This is in medium, light medium. So I'm gonna keep that aside. This is the Maybelline Age Rewind Concealer in light pale. This is an amazing concealer to have, guys. All you need is a very little product. And then we have the ColourPop No Filter Concealer. This is in the shade medium 30, which is an amazing concealer. And then we have the Maybelline Fit Me in Sand Sable. So I'm gonna use things that are available here very easily in India. So this is it, Maybelline Fit Me in Sand Sable. I love this product. Maybelline makes one of the most amazing mascaras and concealers, I have to say. So by just concealing, my face appears to be very flat, like you can see, and I don't like that look on myself personally. You can obviously stop at concealing, but this is about highlighting and contouring. So what I typically do is highlight my face with a second concealer. So what we're gonna do is start bringing dimension to our face, right? We wanna enhance our features. That's why we highlight and contour. So like you can see, I'm applying like dots of it. I'm not going all crazy like they do, like in a big V. Like, I don't want to do that. It just is too much underneath the eye. So I'm going to take the same beauty sponge and start buffing it in. So like you can see, it's already highlighted over here. So I'm gonna bring whatever product I have just right down. I'm not gonna put any extra product. So I'm just going to buff whatever I have all over my cheek and my under eye. Now that we're done with highlighting our face, you want to set it as soon as possible because it is going to start creasing otherwise. And I have tiny little crease lines here, so I have to set it immediately. I go in with the Laura Mercier translucent setting powder. This is my favorite setting powder ever. I prefer using loose powders under my eye because, I mean, that's my most favorite way to set my eye. Now it depends what works for you. Again, it's person to person. You don't have to use a setting powder. You can use a compact powder, but for me personally, a setting powder, specifically Laura Mercier, works. Another good dupe is not a dupe, but another powder that's available here is the Bharat and Doris powder in number 7. This is slightly tinted though. This is more so translucent. Another powder you can use is the PAC powder in TL09. Again, this is also has a slight tint to it. So what I like to use is a translucent powder to highlight my eye. So what I'm going to do is use a little bit of the Laura Mercier underneath to bake. So now I do not bake the entire portion because I have dry skin, and I, you know, sort of want to keep it luminous. So I'm gonna take this tapered brush. It has a pointy end which helps for my baking. So I'm just gonna go right underneath, like right here, just setting the lid. That's all. Like literally that's all I bake. I don't even do anything extra because I stopped putting powder all over my face. I want my face to be a little luminous. However, I have to set my face. If you want your face makeup to stay for a very long time, you know, you want sort of that longevity, you don't want it to budge at all. I found like an amazing method, and I've been doing this like for a while now, and you know, I've been out for shoots and like long days, and I come back home and I put it on Snapchat usually. If you're not following me, definitely follow me. And I update you guys on how my foundation has still stayed intact after the entire day. My concealer doesn't budge, my face makeup doesn't budge, it stays put. So this is what I do and this is what I'm sharing with you. Okay, so as that is sitting to bake, I'm gonna take the Nykaa Skin Genius Compact Powder. This has been an amazing powder to me. This is in the shade Natural Ivory. I love this, guys. It comes in more shades now. I will have it listed down below, but this is such a brilliant compact powder. Even the MAC Studio Fix is good. I think Studio Fix. I used to use that a lot, but ever since I found this, this works perfectly, guys. You know what this does? This powder melts into the skin. It literally mattifies your face and melts into the skin, which is like perfect for me. And I use this brush. This is like a dense, huge, poofy brush. It's not a loose brush like this. So this is more of a loose brush and this is more of a dense brush. This is the Sephora number 54, I think. No, 61. This is the Sephora 61. And this sort of a brush is very good, or a poof, you know, like a poof thing is very good to set your face. So what I'm gonna do is, I haven't set the entire face, but I want my makeup to last an entire day. So setting it is key. You cannot walk out of the house with just foundation and, you know, hoping it would last, because you do put your hand on your face, etc., and it does budge. So what I'm gonna do is, I took some powder, tap off the excess, and you wanna start pressing the compact powder into your skin. So like you can see, it immediately mattifies your skin, and as time passes by, it starts melting and, you know, it becomes skin-like and luminous. That's why I love this compact powder. You can't tell that it is, you know, powdery. It doesn't give you that powdery effect. So I'm gonna push. So if you don't have this powder or you don't get it where you're at, you can definitely use any setting powder, but the technique is important. It's very important to push the powder in to your skin like that. Just put a little bit of pressure and make sure you're setting your face. I have been doing this, guys, and I love this method. So now I'm just gonna get rid of the powder underneath my eyes. So once we have our face set, we're gonna move on to our contouring. I'm gonna use powder products because obviously we set our face and I don't like liquid contour. That's not what I'm about. So I'm gonna use the Smashbox contour palette. This is such a brilliant palette, guys. I am obsessed with this and I have been using this ever since I got it. It's like the perfect travel palette. Bronzer, contour and highlighting under the eye. And I have been using this. So what I'm gonna do is, first I bronze and then I start contouring. Okay, so I'm going to take this middle shade right here. This is like the perfect warm bronzer. You'll pick up whatever bronzer you have first, okay? Any warm bronzer. And I'm going to take this on Pro Art number 6. This is a very small but very loose brush. It gives me control as to where I want my bronzer to be. So I'm going to take this, tap off always, and start. So I'm going to start bronzing. I'm going to start at the higher part of my face and I'm just gonna go down like that. Okay, so a few things to remember is, you will always contour upwards and towards your temple. Now, if you have a small forehead, you will not contour around because it's gonna diminish your forehead, making it look even smaller. You want a big forehead. So I have a very small forehead, so I don't like to go all around, but I'll definitely go at the sides at least. If you have a large forehead and you want to sort of diminish it, make it look smaller, so you will take your bronzer around and start contouring all around. So it gives an illusion of a smaller forehead. Okay. Okay, so now you can automatically see my face having dimensions. Like, can you see this is sort of shrunk in and this portion is sort of standing out because we've highlighted it so much. So remember never to bring your contour or bronzer down. You will always end it where your ear begins. That's where you're gonna bronze and up. Okay, so this gives sort of a pulled back face. It sort of elongates your face and gives you like a facelift without having to go under the knife. So usually people bronze very messily and they sort of do this when they contour, like this. Okay, straight up, but that is wrong. According to me, you can do whatever you want, but according to me, if you bronze straight up, it's gonna give you a flat face, like a square face, and you don't want to contour like this. You want to contour like this, so you want to bring it back. So another brush that I have been loving to contour is the Pro Art number 32 brush. This is a very tiny angle brush. It's very dense and very tiny. I recently found this in Beauty Palace. You can check online or you can find a similar brush like this. If you don't find that, you can buy the NYX number 5 again. So basically to contour, you want a smaller brush. Never pick a bigger brush. Bigger brushes are always for bronzing. So this is again the number 05. This is very good to contour too because it's so tiny. Okay, so now I'm gonna take this cool tone shade right here with this angle brush and I'm gonna mix it with the bronzer, so both of them, and I'm gonna tap off because you don't want to use more of a cool toned color, especially this one, because it's very pigmented. It can get ashy very soon, so it can look muddy all around. So you want to keep that in mind and apply the tiniest amount of product and build up from there. So what I'm gonna do is, you know, I'm gonna start here and push it back, right? All the way into my hairline so it looks sort of blended. Like I'm barely touching my skin, like barely even. Can you see that line? That's what's gonna give you a very sculpted face. So again. And also contour your jawline. So you wanna go a little bit underneath to cast a shadow and just blend it down. Okay, so you want to take your stippling brush and start blending this out because there is a line that I can see. So you want to start pushing the product. So now we're going to move on to contouring the nose. I found an amazing contouring brush. This is the Pro Art PF 14 brush. This is how it looks. It is absolutely beautiful. It's such a tiny, dense, flat brush. And I'm going to start contouring. I'm going to show you how easy it is to contour with this brush. Like, all you got to do is this. Take it all the way up to your brow bone, always. That's it. It is that simple. It is such a good product, guys. I love it. Okay, another tip to remember is the closer you draw these two lines, the narrower your nose is going to look. The more far apart you draw it, the more wider and fat your nose is going to look. Always keep the stippling brush handy, guys. This is very, very important. This is a duo fiber brush. This is the pack 306. Yeah, this is the pack 306, and you want to make sure you're always buffing whatever you contour or highlight or whatever. You make sure you want to blend it. You don't want it to look like two straight lines coming down your nose. The final step is highlighting with powder. Now you can stop right here, just bronzing, contouring, we're good to go. But I'm gonna show you what I do when I go out, and this is what I've been doing, right? Okay, this is my updated contour routine, I keep saying it. So what I've been doing is taking this highlighting matte cream powder and sort of putting it underneath to highlight. Very little of it. You can take a banana powder if you have. I'm gonna use the Sephora brush 56. You can use any brush that is like this, very dense, not a loose brush, but a dense brush that can pack on the white powder. So I'm gonna take this, coat my brush with it, and I'm going to start putting it underneath. So what I'm doing is basically sharpening my nose contour and also highlighting under the eyes. Can you see the difference? I can see it. You can see how it's instantly brightened my face, and I have been loving this. I used to never do this. I never understood why people did it, but when I started doing it and I saw myself in photographs, girl, dude, your contour looks slayed. Like, it looks beat. And this might be too much for some people. It really can get a bit too much for people who don't wear makeup, but I mean, sorry guys, because this is what I do and I've been loving it. you. So now I'm gonna put this over here as well. Again, like you can see, this is the center part. Can you see my face has dimensions now? Like my under eyes lit up, my cheeks have been contoured. All of this is contouring and highlighting. It's very important to understand your face structure, what you don't want, what you want. So I'm gonna take some of this and start cleaning up the contour. Can you see how it instantly chiseled my jaw? And by the way, I'm not sponsored to do this by Smashbox or anything. This is just an amazing product and I thought I would let you guys know. I'm just gonna really lightly clean out the contour. It really gives that, I love the way my jawline looks like. I love it. So, understanding your face shape is really important, guys. Look into the mirror for a while and see your face shape, what you don't want. Try understanding your face structure, which is really, really important. Okay, now I'm gonna take a stippling brush and sort of blend everything out. Like I said, I always blend the things I do on my face. I'm gonna never leave it like that. So keep blending. Okay, so I'm back for my favorite step in makeup, in the makeup process. It's highlighting. I'm going to use the Makeup Revolution Pro Illuminate. Thank you for introducing me to this, guys. Thank you so much. If it wasn't for you, I would have never ordered this product. So thank you. This is a beautiful drugstore highlighter. So if you are looking for a blinding, golden-y champagne highlighter, this is perfect. So what I'm gonna do is start highlighting my nose first. Very important. If you highlight the center part of your nose, it's going to make your nose look even slimmer. Okay, so it's a nose job without having to go under the knife. So I'm gonna take this with on a pencil brush. This is the ProArt 248 e-brush. You can take any brush that is, you know, slightly domed. Basically a tiny little brush. It doesn't have to be this particular brush. And we're gonna start highlighting. So what you're gonna do is start from here and go all the way to your, to the tip of your nose. Exactly like that. Okay, so can you see that line? So that is what's gonna make the nose look really slim, even in pictures. So there you go, highlight the tip of your nose. If you want, you can highlight this part. For some people, it looks like snot, but it really depends on personal preference. I'm gonna highlight my inner corner and brow bone really quickly. Okay, to highlight my face, I'm gonna take the Sigma Tapered Highlighter Brush in F35. I love this brush. Again, any brush that is tiny like this or a fan brush. My fan brush is Beat. You guys reminded me of that. So I'm gonna start highlighting. I also love the Mary Luminizer by The Balm. That's my favorite highlighter. One of my favorite highlighters. Now, to highlight your face, you're going to highlight your cheekbone area. Do not bring it underneath because then it's going to defeat the purpose of, you know, structuring your face. So you want to highlight it at the topmost part of your face and you want to drag it up. Again, this sort of pulls back your face, brings attention. If you have texture going on your cheek, avoid using highlighter because it brings attention to the areas you don't want. So what I do is I highlight this part, a little bit on my cheek because I don't have texture there and I really like it on my cheek. And you want to highlight this portion and also your temple area. So when you're highlighting above your brow bone, it gives an illusion of a lifted face. So you get an automatic facelift. So your brow looks lifted with the highlight. So as opposed to this, which is like flat and fallen, this looks nice and lifted. So you want to sort of put it right above the arch or arc. I don't know how you say that, arch of your brow bone. Okay, so if you do not like the blinding highlight, you want to take your beauty sponge and start pushing the highlighter into the skin, which sort of gives you that very natural glow. Okay, and for the finished look, you always, always want to apply a setting spray or, you know, fixing mist, anything that you have. I'm using the Prep and Prime by MAC. This is the Fix Plus. This melts all the powder. We've put so much powder on our face right now, you know, the translucent powder, a highlighting powder, contour powder. So when you come up close to someone, you don't want to look powdered. You want to look sort of like skin. Even though you've applied so much makeup, you want to sort of melt it into your skin. And Fix Plus is amazing for that. It sort of just melts everything and brings out your highlighter, which is amazing. I'm using a blush now. This is Berry Amour by Milani. I love this. It's got gold reflex in it. It's so pretty. I'm using the brush ProArt 176F. And all you need is a little bit. So basically, you just sort of start at the apples of your cheek and take the blush back. So always push it up back. Don't just put it on the apples of your cheek. Apples of your face. Apples of your cheek. And let it be. You want to sort of push the product back so it again, you know, ties all the products together. So same thing on this side. You want to start here and push it up. So that is all I have for you. I hope you enjoyed watching this video and I hope you learned something new. I love you all so very much and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys.